I sent all of these popular nattokinase products to a lab to be third-party tested. And unlike the first video, I tested a few more that I wasn't even familiar with. And we've got some winners and some losers. Do you know what third-party tested actually means? Third-party tested simply means that a product has been tested by a lab that has no affiliation with that product or company. Notice I said tested, but I didn't say for what. That's because third-party tested, unless it clarifies, does not refer to any specific type of test. And unfortunately, some companies are misleading you while technically telling you the truth. Let's say you like this product. You like the price, the ingredients, and what really spikes your confidence is this little emblem right here. Third party, lab tested. In your mind, this means the product has been tested for contaminants, heavy metals, the identity of the ingredients, and surely the strength of the product, all by a third party lab, right? There's one big problem though. A blanket third party or lab tested statement without any other information could really mean anything. Dietary supplement manufacturers are required to be cGMP compliant, which means they must follow the guidelines of FDA's current good manufacturing practices. The guidelines mandate that supplements are to be tested for identity, purity, weight, contaminants, strength, pathogenic microbes, stability, and there are other specialized product-specific analyses like enzyme activity assays and probiotic viability measurements. And this isn't even an exhaustive list, since some companies add in their own testing, like testing for GMOs, pesticides, and other types of contaminants. I point this out because technically, a company may choose to only have one of these tests performed by a third party. Maybe it's only the milligram content of the main ingredient. But what if you're concerned about another aspect of the product, like enzyme activity, which we're talking about today? Now, if a company chooses to do this, they are technically being accurate when they state that their product is third-party tested. But as you can see, this can be very misleading. So if independent testing matters to you, be sure to find out exactly what's being tested. Reputable manufacturers with nothing to hide should be more than willing to share this information. If they don't, consider why and whether or not there's a better option that does. Okay, finally to what you've been waiting for, the third-party test results. On this chart in gray, we can see the potency that each product claims to provide taken from their labels. And in green, we can see the actual potency that was revealed in the third-party testing. Wow, and right away, I can see why these products are so popular. The first thing that jumps out is the fact that all of these products tested significantly higher than their label claim. And in regards to their label value, Zymogen and Nattovena both tested extremely well. But for all of these products, what I can tell you is that this extra activity is a good thing. High quality enzyme products are almost always going to be overformulated. This is because we're not just dealing with a fixed amount of a nutrient, like a vitamin that's measured in milligrams. Instead, we're dealing with enzymatic activity, which naturally decreases over time, and these manufacturers are allowing for that natural loss. The extra in all of these products tells me that no matter how old or new the product is, so long as it's not expired, you're always getting at least the amount of activity listed on the label. Now, let's move on to a few products that I was not familiar with. We've got Double Wood. Says here, nattokinase, 4,000 fibrinolytic units. First thing I notice is it's a 2-capsule dose. So really, it's 2,000 fibrinolytic units per capsule, just like most of the other products from the first video. Then we've got Wellness Labs. This was interesting because it's liposomal, and it says that it's 5,000 fibrinolytic units. And it looks like it's a 1-capsule dose. So that could potentially be very strong. Then we've got this product, another interesting formula. It says that it's 6,000 fibrinolytic units. It's Phytomedics nattokinase. And when I flip it over, it's a 2-capsule dose. So it's not as strong as I thought, but it is 3,000, or at least it states that it's 3,000 per capsule. And then finally, we've got this product made by Zenavia, which I thought was interesting. It was just a cool looking product. I liked the all black. It was pretty sleek. Zenavia Nattokinase, 2,000 fibrinolytic units per capsule. Nothing special there, but it was a fairly good looking product. Okay, let's take a look at the potency of each product that I just went over. You can see the activity on their label per capsule here in gray. Let's go ahead and add in the actual third-party tested activity. And that's not a mistake. Yikes. This was not supposed to be a gotcha video, but it might turn out to be that way. First thing I noticed was that three of the four products failed the third-party test. The Zenavia product, which at first glance I thought would perform very well, didn't even test high enough to score a value. The test can only measure 15 fibrinolytic units, so I can't say that it doesn't have any activity, but I can be pretty close by saying it's less than 15. Then we've got the Phytomedic and the Wellness RX products, both testing well below the stated label value. But I wasn't all that surprised. The supposed liposomal product doesn't even appear to have a liposome in the ingredients, which would be some type of lipid or fat. I don't know any of this for sure, but in my opinion, it's not a coincidence when a liposomal product that doesn't appear to even be liposomal doesn't pass a potency test. And second to that, the Phytomedic product is made in Colombia, and I don't think they have very many checks and balances. So, what can we learn from all this? Well, I think it's obvious that we need to be able to trust the companies that are making the products we take. Popular companies, which at times can be more expensive, are like that for a reason. They take the time to deliver what they promise, and they do this by testing and then retesting their products every step of the manufacturing process. Unfortunately, there are bad apples that can make the entire industry look bad. That's why you should always take products from companies that are more than happy to share third and first party testing with you. Remember, the dietary supplement industry is one of the last free markets left in our country. There will always be bad actors, but with word of mouth, videos like this, and your hard-earned cash, we can weed out the bad and reward the good. If you enjoyed this content, please make sure to like it and share it with your friends and family. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Again, I'm Danny Curtin. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one.